Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker is now just around the corner from its release into theaters around the world, and a lot of fans are very excited and are worried about this movie. And of course, a lot of fans are also very curious as to exactly where this is going to lead the future of the Star Wars franchise. This is Mike Zero. Make sure to subscribe if you're new to the channel for future content. Now, of course, we do know that Kathleen Kennedy, president of Lucasfilm, has a lot of plans in place for the future of the franchise beyond Episode 9. We're talking about the new Star Wars trilogy, a handful of live-action Star Wars TV series for Disney+, and other projects that are currently in the works, such as spin-off films that they are currently planning, as well as new animated TV series out there, like The Clone Wars and other animated series currently in the works. Now, on top of all of this, I wanted to go over what Kathleen Kennedy had to say recently and why it really confuses me as a fan. Now, she states, "I have to say it's a mixture of emotions. I have to say because we've had such an incredible time, it's just flown by these 5 years and doing these three movies and to realize that we're completing the saga and we're not finishing the Skywalkers necessarily. They could always, in one way or another, reappear, but for right now, it is bringing it to a close." Alright, so what does that really mean for the Star Wars franchise? What does that actually mean for, of course, the Skywalkers as a whole? Now, for one, I think I could really say that this means that Kathleen Kennedy, Disney, and Lucasfilm really have no idea exactly what they are really doing with the franchise and exactly how they should handle the franchise, right? The fact that she states that it doesn't necessarily mean that they are done with the Skywalkers and that they will be, you know, pretty much returning in some way, shape, or form. Now, we're not quite sure exactly what that means by Kathleen Kennedy. That could either mean in the form of a movie or in the form of a live-action TV series. What do I make about all of this? Well, I think that Disney Lucasfilm have some form of insurance here. If they ever wanted to go back to the Skywalker saga, they could in some way, shape, or form if they really wanted to. Do I think that they're going to do that? Not necessarily. What do I make about this? Well, it could very well have something to do with the talks that we've been actually discussing, that Disney and Lucasfilm have been debating on developing a young Luke Skywalker TV series for Disney Plus that we talked about a couple of weeks ago. It could also have something to do with a young Luke Skywalker around the age of 8 years old appearing in the Obi-Wan Kenobi TV series. It could also have something to do with that. But I think that there's something larger at bay here that Kathleen Kennedy is referencing, is that they are actually talking about the bigger scale, right? The actual thing related to the movies, the actual future of the franchise, everything related to the Skywalkers themselves. This could have something to do with Force Ghosts in the future, depending on what movies they want to do and exactly what their new trilogy is going to be based around. You know, it's kind of funny because just the other day, Kathleen Kennedy stated that they're trying to move away from the trilogy format, and then Bob Iger, the CEO of Disney, shot that down and completely debunked that from Kathleen Kennedy, stating that it's still in the cards, that the trilogy is still in the works, and that they still want to actually keep, you know, everything in frame here with the three Star Wars movie format. So like I say, I think that what they really should have done at the end of the day, they should have just kept the end of The Rise of Skywalker open-ended. I'm not going into spoilers, don't worry, but they should have kept the very end of Episode 9 open-ended, where you could absolutely go back to the Skywalker saga in some way, shape, or form, continuing the actual Skywalker bloodline over forward. If you wanted to explore, let's say, for example, different bloodlines or different family members of the Skywalker saga, very much similar to the expanded universe, where we had, let's say, for example, Luke Skywalker's son, or you had, you know, other members of the Solo family. They could have done so much more if they just based these stories a little bit more on the expanded universe. So like I say, that's what Kathleen Kennedy had to say over at the premiere for Star Wars The Rise of Skywalker. It really is a big deal because it tells us, the fans, that Disney and Lucasfilm just don't really know exactly, you know, what they're doing with the franchise beyond the sequel trilogy. Yes, they do have plans for new Star Wars movies already, but as far as the overall structure of their future and of their roadmap, they really have got not a clue as to whether or not, you know, specific things should be finalized or not, right? They keep using that term in the marketing, right? The end of the Skywalker saga. Like, this is the end of the end. Kind of reminds me of what was said back in 2005, right? The last Star Wars movie. I believe it was on one of the magazine covers of Time magazine, if I'm not mistaken. I remember that clearly, you know, it's saying the last Star Wars movie until George Lucas sold Lucasfilm to Disney and they started to make new Star Wars movies, right? So we could very well be in a similar situation here where they could have Luke Skywalker, for example, show up as a Force ghost in some way, shape, or form. That's an example if they want to do something like that. If they want to model the future of the franchise on the Legacy comics, they could do something like that if they wanted to. I don't know if you guys are familiar with the Legacy comics, but it explores characters like Cade Skywalker and all these different aspects of, you know, the Skywalker bloodline. So Kathleen Kennedy, at the end of the day, like I've said many times before in the past, I think that somebody else needs to replace her as head of Lucasfilm. Anybody, just get anybody that's a Star Wars fan or even has more knowledge within the Star Wars franchise. Get anybody like Jon Favreau or Dave Filoni or just somebody that can handle both the business and the creative end of Star Wars. I think that you're golden at that point in time. Again, I love what Jon Favreau has done with The Mandalorian. In fact, episode 6 and 7 were solid. Pretty much no flaws in those episodes as far as I can tell. And it really just shows how creative Jon Favreau really is. Again, this is the man that brought us Iron Man 1. You know, Iron Man 1 was a hit. I mean, back in 2008, it really kickstarted the MCU. It's all because of Jon Favreau, really, at the end of the day. You know, and I think the fact that he's created the MCU, essentially, like, really brought it to its existence and created the foundation of it all. You know, I really gotta give Jon Favreau a lot of credit here, because this is also a man who is creating the foundation of the live-action TV series on Disney Plus, and how all the TV series on Disney Plus are going to interconnect in a similar way to the MCU. So with Kathleen Kennedy saying that, you know, they're not necessarily done with the Skywalkers per se, and that they will come back in some way, shape, or form in the future, you know, that they're not totally ruling that out, really is a big deal, because it tells us that they are going to do something bigger, either with movies or TV series surrounding the Skywalkers, so keep an eye open for that. I think that they realize at the end of the day here that really, Star Wars fans love the Skywalker bloodline. It really is the heart of the Star Wars franchise. It really is. When we look at the Star Wars franchise, the Skywalkers really are the heart of it all. Unless you want to look at other aspects like, you know, the Old Republic or Knights of the Old Republic, which is something that more so the hardcore fans are more knowledgeable in. But as far as casual fans, right? The casual fan out there, more so look at the Skywalker saga, right? They look at the Skywalkers in general. We're talking about Anakin, Luke, Leia, and so on and so forth. And other characters like Han Solo and Chewbacca, other characters that are associated with the Skywalker saga. And it's very sad that we're moving away from that and we are moving on to something new, yet it's also very intriguing to see exactly whether or not Disney and Lucasfilm can take on that challenge, whether or not they can change their ways to handle things better. There's no doubt about it that The Last Jedi was by far the worst Star Wars movie in existence. I'm very, you know, honest about that. It really is the worst of the worst. I actually enjoyed The Phantom Menace way better than that of The Last Jedi. I've expressed this several times. So yeah, guys, Kathleen Kennedy saying that, of how she says that, you know, it's just flown by these 5 years and doing these three movies and to realize that we're completing the saga and we're not finishing the Skywalkers necessarily. You know, that really is confusing, right? You market the movie like, alright, the end of the Skywalker saga, but yet, at the same exact time, we're not finishing the Skywalkers necessarily. You know, what does that really mean? We're not quite sure. Like I said, it could have something to do with Disney Plus, or it could have something else to do with something far bigger, like movies, for example. So, with that being said, guys, I mean, here we are, today, December 19th, the movie's gonna release, a lot of fans are gonna express their opinions. It's gonna be an interesting ride to see exactly how the fans will react to it all, what the Rotten Tomatoes score is gonna look like on the audience score. So yeah, with that being said, guys, I would really love to hear each and every one of you and what you have to say about this below in the comments and what you make about Kathleen Kennedy's statement. And if you guys did enjoy the content for today, do make sure to drop a thumbs up on this video to support the channel. I thank you also very much for the kind support, and I'll catch you guys next time.